Recall the call center example that we studied in class. We were trying to figure out how many trainees we need to recruit to be 99% sure that we're going to end up with at least 80 new employees. Now remember, we had the probability of success was 80%. That was the probability that a trainee would become a full-time employee. And then the yellow cell represents the number of trials. That's the number of trainees that we're going to try to recruit. So we don't know exactly what that number is, but it's going to be presumably more than 100. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the BINOM.INV formula. This is a binomial situation as we described in class. So here what we're going to do is we're going to use the BINOM.INV function. And the number of trials is going to be their yellow cell. I'm going to put dollar signs to make this an absolute reference so we can copy the formula down and maintain the same value. And then the probability of success, that's the 0.8, which is in cell B3. And then the alpha value, or the criterion values, need to be a number between 0 and 1, and we want to simulate this, and we're going to use a random number generation to figure out what we're going to get here. And now, when we run this, we get 81 new employees on that particular run. Now, for calculation options, I've set this to manual so that I control when the cells are recalculated. I just need to click calculate now, and I'll get a different number each time I rerun this simulation. Now, if I want to do this 1,000 times, I just need to copy the formula down 1,000 times. Now, it's saying 72 each time because I haven't recalculated the cells. But now, if I click recalculate now, I'll get a different number of full-time employees from each of the simulations. So now what I'm going to do is figure out how many times did it come up as 80 or more. So first let's figure out how many times I get 79, less than 79. In all cases here it's useful to use the Countif formula, and we're going to Countif for the whole range of simulations that we have, which runs, it's 1,000 times, and it's in cells B13 all the way to B1012. And then the criteria is that it's equal to what I have in the cell D6. And so that's going to tell me how many times I get the value that's less than 79. Now if I want to, I'll copy this formula down. It'll tell me how many times I get exactly 79 and how many times I get greater than 79. And it's greater than 79, or greater than or equal to 80 is what I'm looking for here. So I'm going to copy this formula, and I'm going to paste special. I'm going to paste the formulas. Now if I recalculate the cells, I have the different frequency, the different times I get less than 79, equal to 79, or greater than 79. And if I sum those, I should get 1,000 because there are 1,000 different iterations of the simulation. Okay, now let's see as a percentage. It's not so difficult to calculate when we have a nice round number like 1,000, but sometimes you might have a different number of simulations that you're running. So let's see, we just do this number divided by the total number. In this case, we put dollar signs at E9, so we can copy the formulas down again. And then I'll paste special just to paste the formulas so that I keep the formatting that we have here. I recalculate, of course, the relative frequencies are as we expect, and if we sum those up, they should sum to 1. Now, as we can see, if we have 100 trainees with 80% probability of success, we will not be 99% sure to get those 80 employees. We did get 80 employees 553 times out of the 1,000 simulations. But that really means we're only 55% sure that we're going to get the 80 employees. So we're definitely going to need to increase this number. Let's try increasing it to 105. And then when we recalculate, now we're getting 86% sure on this particular run, where we have 860 out of 1,000 times where we got 80 or more employees. Now if we run it again, we're going to get some slightly different results, but generally speaking, it seems 105 is not enough. Well, let's try 110. Well, now if we try 110, we get 97, but not quite 99. So let's try 111. Then we got 98, not quite 99. Then if we try 112, when we simulate, we got 99% that time. This time, though, we only got 98.5%, so we might need even one more to be more confident. So we'll get 113, we run in there. Sure enough, we get 99.6% of the time, 99.7% of the time. So it seems that 113 are the number of trainees that we need to hire to be 99% sure that we'll have 80 new employees. Now, if we want to calculate some more summary measures for a simulation, we can just calculate the average of the whole range. So again, this is going to be to 1012. And then we might be interested in knowing the standard deviation over the same range. And then our minimum and maximum. So out of our runs that we have here, the most employees we got was 102, and the least we got was 76. And we're 99% sure that we will have 80 or more employees.